Hello students, in today's mathematics session we are going to learn the first chapter of your 10th mathematics textbook, and that was real numbers. And I will start the class on real numbers with the importance of numbers. Our life is full of numbers. Imagine the moment you are born. Probably your parents may know that the date and the time you were born. It happened with the help of numbers. From then we are with the numbers throughout the life. We use numbers in different contexts, such as measuring the ages, measuring the heights, tracking our incomes, calculating the wealth, and even measuring our health also possible with the numbers. All these different human requirements are possible with different types of numbers. In some situation we use fractions, and in some other situation we use negative numbers, and in the case of counting we use counting numbers. All these human requirements are simplified by the mathematics. For all the requirements and to simplify the day-to-day activities, mathematics is continuously developing the number systems, starting from the natural numbers to the real numbers, and it even extends the collection of real numbers further as imaginary and complex numbers too. And at present we are at real numbers. In your earlier classes we all learnt about naturals, whole numbers, integers, rationals and irrationals. Naturals, whole numbers, integers in your 6th and 7th classes, rationals in 8th class, whereas irrationals in your 9th class. And now we are at real numbers. See, to say simply, real numbers are nothing but just, it is a combination of both rational and irrational. What I mean, the collection of the union of rationals and irrationals together forms real numbers. Let us see the complete analysis of the classification of numbers with the real numbers. Real numbers. As I said, real numbers are the union of both rationals and irrationals. Real numbers. These real numbers are denoted by the letter R, capital R, and it is the union of rationals, rational numbers plus irrational numbers. Already we learnt about these rationals and irrationals in our previous classes. These rational numbers are also known as quotient numbers. As per its name, quotient, these rational numbers are denoted by the letter Q. The general form of the rational numbers is given by the form P by Q, such that P and Q are integers and Q is different from zero. This is the general form of the rationals. We know that this P is termed as numerator of the rational and Q as denominator of the rational. Both this P and Q are from integers, and that Q is different from zero. This is the general form of rationals. And these rationals are denoted by the letter Q. And now let us go with few examples related to the rationals. First, suppose if I say the numbers of the format 3 by 7. If you look at 3 by 7, P is 3, Q is 7, both are integers and the denominator is non-zero. So it is of the form P by Q, and it is of the form of the rational, so we call that 3 by 7 as a rational number. And for suppose, if we have a number something like minus 8 by 17, here again, P is minus 8, Q is 17, and both that P and Q are integers, the denominator is non-zero, so this 8 by 17 is again a rational. And now, let us look at these type of numbers. Some 9 divided by 1. What you say? Whether it is rational or not? If you check whether it is rational or not, by this form P by Q. This P is 9 and Q is 1. Both are integers and the denominator is a non-zero. So clearly, this 9 by 1 is a rational number. And as a calculation, this 9 by 1 is nothing but simply 9. And for suppose, if you consider a number, something like 0 divided by 11. Look at the number 0 by 11. Here again, both the numerator P and the denominator 11, both are integers and the denominator is non-zero. Again, we mention this 0 by 11 is in the form of rational. So this is a rational number. For suppose, if you consider a number of this format, 7 divided by 0. If you look at this number 7 by 0, the Q value, the denominator value is 0. That's why this is not in the form of P by Q. Because rational numbers are such numbers which are in the form P by Q, where that Q can't be 0. But here, for our number 7 by 0, the denominator Q is 0. So, this is not satisfying the general form of rational. That's why this is not a rational number. And as calculation, if you move, the value of 7 by 0 is a very, very larger unknown value. And mathematically, we represent that larger unknown value as infinity. This infinity, the larger unknown value of the form anything divided by 0. Not only this 7 by 0, you may consider some 9 by 0, 10 by 0, anything divided by 0 is a very, very unknown larger value. All these numbers whose denominators are zeros are not included in these rationals because they fail in satisfying the form of rational. So, from there I will conclude that every rational is finite because infinite values are not included in the rationals. No rational is infinite. See, this 7 by 0 infinity as well as negatively larger value minus infinity. Both those numbers are not included in rationals. This is something about the rational numbers. Now, if you look at the irrationals. Irrational numbers, simply if you say, irrational numbers are the numbers which are not rationals. Since irrationals are the numbers which are not rationals, those irrational numbers are denoted by the letter Q dash, which indicates that Q complement means numbers which are not rationals. Since these are the numbers which are not rationals, we define these irrationals as the numbers which are not in P by Q form. In another way, as you learnt in your 9th class, irrational numbers are the numbers which are neither terminating nor repeating decimals. Neither terminating nor repeating decimals. Already you learnt about it in your 9th standard that these type of decimals are termed as irrational numbers. Whereas we have terminating decimals and repeating decimals. All these type of decimals, easily we can convert them into rational form. So, rational numbers, the decimal representation of rational numbers contains terminating decimals and repeating decimals, whereas neither terminating nor repeating decimals are termed as, mentioned as irrational numbers. We need to discuss about this decimal conversion of the rationals and irrationals in this particular chapter, but in some other class. Now, see, let us go with some examples of irrationals. You know that the decimal expansions of the numbers such as root 2, root 3, like that. Look at the numbers root 2, root 3, like that. You learn the division process to calculate the decimal expansion for such numbers. All these numbers are neither terminating nor repeating decimals. So, we call all the numbers of such format as irrationals. Square root of all non-perfect squares are irrationals. And now, when you look at these rationals are again classified in two parts. Rationals whose denominator is 1 and rationals whose denominator is not equals to 1. That means these rationals are classified into two parts. In one part, the value of Q is 1, whereas in other classification, the value of Q is not equals to 1. If Q is 1, denominator is 1, then in such case, if you collect the numbers, we call all these numbers as integers. And in this case, where the denominator is not equals to 1, we call all such numbers as fractions. See, here in the above examples, 3 by 7, minus 8 by 17, etc. are fractions. And among these fractions, fractions of the form 3 by 7 is mentioned as positive fraction, and fractions of the form minus 8 by 17 is mentioned as negative fraction. And when coming for the integers, the denominator, the rationals whose denominator is 1 is termed as integer. We learnt in our previous class that there are many integers. Integers consist of the negative numbers 0 along with the positive numbers. See, the negative number integers is a combination of positive numbers and its opposite numbers along with 0. That's why, since opposite numbers are included in integers, by the term opposite, these integers are denoted by the letter Z. Why? Because in Greek language, opposite means zenith. By the word zenith, these integers are denoted by the letter Z. And in some cases, some people may denote these integers by the symbol I. So, integers are denoted by either I or Z, and this is the collection of integers. And again, if you look at these integers, there are classification is possible. If you look at this, I will classify these integers again into three parts. In one part, I will collect all the positive integers, and in the other part, I will collect zero, and in some other part, I will collect negative integers. And if you look, these 1, 2, 3, and so on, all these numbers are termed as positive integers. And these positive integers are denoted by the letter Z plus. Have a look at this. Z plus is positive integers, collection of the positive numbers. And this 0 is neither positive nor negative integer. And whereas this minus 3, minus 2, minus 1 are negative integers. And these negative integers are denoted by the letter Z minus. And again, if you look, these positive integers are mentioned as natural numbers, and those natural numbers along with zero are termed as whole numbers. See, positive integers are again mentioned as naturals, and these naturals together with zero are termed as whole numbers. Look at this. This is the complete classification of number systems. Look at this. Real numbers is a union of both rationals and irrationals. The form of the rationals is P by Q, such that P and Q are integers and the Q is not equals to 0. Whereas irrational numbers are neither terminating nor repeating decimals. As you learnt in your previous class, these are few examples related to the irrationals. And these rationals are classified as integers and fractions. And among these integers, we have some other classification as positive integers, zero, and negative integers. These positive integers are also mentioned as naturals. Because the positive integers starts from 1, 2, 3 and so on, we call these numbers as generally counting numbers. Those counting numbers are nothing but naturals. And we know that natural numbers along with zero are mentioned as whole numbers and denoted by the letter W. See, look at this. From this complete analysis, I may generate some facts, some statements related to the number system. If you look, every natural numbers are part of integers. Natural numbers are part of integers. So I may say that every natural number is an integer. And integers are part of rationals. So it is easy for us to say that every integer is rational. And rational numbers are part of reals. So it is very clear that every rational is a real number. But every real number is not a rational, because there are some other real numbers which are not rational. For example, here we have irrationals, and every rational number is not an integer, because there are some other numbers which are not integers in rationals, and specifically here they are fractions. And every integer is not a natural, because there are some other numbers in integers which are not naturals, and they are specifically negative integers. And if you look at this, positive integers along with zero and negative integers. Positive integers starts from 1, 2, 3 and moves like that, whereas negative integers starts from minus 1 and the value 1 by 1 it gets decreased, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 and so on. And if you look at this zero is neither positive nor negative integer. This zero is neither positive nor negative integer. And if you look once again, these are the positive integers. And this is neither positive nor negative integer. If you consider this zero along with the positive integers, what I am going to tell you is, you need to consider positive integers plus zero. Look at this. These positive integers along with zero are termed as non-negative integers. You may just consider that positive integers and zero. See, I am going to indicate that positive integers and zero. Look at this. See, collecting positive integers along with zero is nothing but neglecting negative integers from the total integers. That's why we call the collection of zero plus z plus as non-negative integers. See, this collection is mentioned as non-negative integers. In the similar fashion, if you collect the negative integers along with zero, collecting negative integers along with zero is nothing but neglecting and removing positive integers from the total integers. That means the collection of these two, negative integers along with zero, is termed as non-positive integers. That's what I need to mention here. Negative integers and the zero both together are termed as non-positive integers. These are termed as non-negative and these are termed as non-positive integers. Yeah, let us have a look at the complete analysis of the numbers. And with this classification, we may answer some simple questions. See, what you say about the least positive integer. If you look at these positive integers, and among all those numbers, one is the least positive integer. And if anybody asks you to identify the greatest non-positive integers, what is the greatest non-positive integer? If you look at this, these are the positive integers. And the non-positive integers are the negative integers along with zero, as I mentioned here. So, non-positive integers are continuously like this, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, and then 0. And among all those numbers, this 0 is the greatest one. That's why we call this 0 as the greatest non-positive integer. And whereas coming for the integers, we don't have the least value as well as the greatest value. Why? Because the integers are continuously rising one by one, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on. Right? And this is the complete analysis of the number system. Let us analyze the classification of numbers in another way. Start with naturals. First, suppose if I have natural numbers. We know that naturals are counting numbers like 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. See, this is the collection of natural numbers. And for suppose, if you add 0 for these naturals, then this new collection is termed as whole numbers. This is the collection of whole numbers. And now, if you add opposite numbers of these positive numbers, negatives of these naturals, which are nothing but the negative integers, for this whole numbers, then they are like this, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, and so on. Then this total collection, the combination of negative numbers, 0, and along with these naturals, all together are termed as integers. And if you add for the collection of this integers collect group some fractions like 3 by 7 minus 8 by 9, something like that. If you add some fractions for these integers, then this newly formed collection, integers along with the fractions, this total group is mentioned as rationals. And irrationals are somewhat different from these rationals. This is all rationals, and irrational numbers are the numbers, as we discussed, irrational numbers are the numbers which are neither terminating nor repeating decimals, and we learnt some examples related to the irrationals like root 2, root 3, and so on. See, these rational numbers along with these irrationals, the combination of these two together is or nothing but our real numbers. Just have a look at this, and from there it is very clear that natural numbers are part of whole numbers, and whole numbers are a part of integers, and integers are a subpart of the rationals, and at the end these rationals along with the irrationals together, rationals and irrationals together, are represented as real numbers, and these real numbers are denoted by the letter R. This is a complete analysis of the classification of number system. Let us look at the slide on your screen. As what we discussed on the board, the slide shows that, initially at the inner circle we have natural numbers, and those natural numbers with zero together forms whole numbers. Whole numbers along with the negative numbers, they forms integers, and integers with the fractions all together, the collection is named as rational numbers. And separately, we have irrational numbers. At the end, those rationals and irrationals together are our real numbers. Let us think about few simple questions related to the what we discussed till now. See, the first question. What is neither positive nor negative integer? And our second question is every integer irrational? And the third one, is zero irrational or not? Whereas the fourth one, do you find any real x such that x square is equals to minus 1? Let us answer these questions. First of all, think about the first one. My question is, what is neither positive nor negative integers? If you look at the collection of integers, we classified integers into two groups as positive integers, zero along with the negative integers. Positive integers starts from 1, 2, 3 and so on. Whereas the negative integers, the collection of integers, we classified it into two groups. Positive integers, they start from 1, 1, 2, 3 and so on. Whereas, the negative integers, they are minus 1, -2, -3, and so on. Along with these positive integers and negative integers, we have another number, 0. And this 0 is considered as neither positive nor negative integer. So, your answer for the first question is 0. Neither positive nor negative integer is 0. And then, let us think about the second one. Is every integer a rational? For suppose, you just take an integer. You may say any integer. For example, you may say some 7 is an integer. And we will write this 7 as 7/1. It is of the form p by q, where that p and q are again integers and that q is a non-zero number. See, since we have a chance to express every integer in the form of rational number, then we conclude that every integer is a rational. Then, at the end, our answer for this question is S. Every integer is a rational number. And let us discuss the third one. Is 0 an irrational? See, look at this 0. 0 is such a number. We can express this 0 as again 0/1. 0 by anything is basically 0. See, 0 can be expressed as 0 by any number. Not only 1, you may take it as 2 or 3, anything. So, we have a chance to express that 0 as 0 by something. And that 0 by something is again satisfying the form of rational number. That's why we mention this 0 as a rational number. And now our question is 0 irrational? Absolutely no. Because 0 is satisfying the form of the rational, so we consider that 0 in the collection of rational numbers. And for this question, your answer is no. 0 is not irrational. Now, think about the fourth one. Do you find any real x such that x square is equals to -1? We need to search all the real numbers. See, you just search in the collection of rationals as well as search in the collection of irrationals to find one x such that x square is -1. We know that x square is the product of x with x is equals to -1. Look at this equation, that x into x is -1. And we are searching for x in the collection of reals. In real numbers, we have different types of numbers. But if you classify them as positive and negative, at the end you have positive reals, negative reals, and along with 0. If you consider this x, if you collect this x from the collection of positive reals, positive real, when multiplied with the positive real, it results as a positive number. So, positive real in the place of x is not our required value. Whereas, if you select that x from the collection of negative reals, negative real, when multiplied with itself, that in the sense, negative real, when you multiply with the again negative real, the product again becomes positive. Is it right? We know that multiplication of a negative number along with the negative number gives us positive. So if you consider x as negative real, again the product becomes positive. That means if you consider negative real in the place of x, again our requirement fails here with the negative real. So I will conclude that a positive real won't work for this equation and a negative real again won't work this for equation. Whereas if you take neither positive nor negative, as we mentioned here, 0 in the place of x, still it fails in satisfying this equation. That in the sense, we don't have any real number x such that x square is equals to -1. So for this question, we can't find a real x such that x square is equals to -1. And at the end, if you think about this question gives an idea that there are still some more numbers which are not reals. Let us look at the slide on our screen. It contains few simple questions related to the class what we discussed today. See, the first question is, what is the greatest non-positive integer? And your second question is, which letter or symbol used to denote non-negative integers? And the third question is, 7/0 irrational or not? Your fourth question is that, do you agree with the statement that all rationals are integers? If yes, give your justification. In this mathematics session, we learnt about the classification of numbers from real numbers to the natural numbers. And you learnt the ideas to operate four fundamental operations, plus, minus, multiplication and division on these numbers in your earlier classes. And now, specifically in this chapter, real numbers, we are going to discuss few special properties related to the numbers, such as Euclid division lemma on integers, fundamental theorem of arithmetics related to the naturals, rational numbers, and irrationality of the numbers. See, in the next class, we are going to discuss about the concept of Euclid's division.